some notes. I guess call it lessons learned. I should have really put my floor together before I sealed it. So now today I've got to cut my 1x2s so I can put my styrofoam insulation in between the 3/4 inch sheets of plywood, so I have some insulation on the bottom of the trailer. Should have done that first. Lesson learned. But hey, I'll go backwards and do this a little differently. This is day 2. This stuff's all rubberized. Nut doesn't come off. So here we are. Anyhow, just making sure here that we're drilling with a full 96 inches, because my 1x2s are a half inch long. So I've got to trim a half inch off of each end here. Not a big deal. My luck, I'll cut it twice and it'll still be too short. I already brought my little miter box out. Set her up and whip this off real quick. In that blade while I'm doing other things. And what I'm going to do is glue it and screw it. So I was going to go get new saw horses today and wound up at my golf club meeting instead, so didn't get my saw horses. I will tomorrow. Tarp on for the winter time, so when it snows out, they keep that snow off at the top. got some new clamps to help hold everything there. Excuse the bad tools, and my wife bought it. They have these clamps, these little 6-inch jobbers, for like $10 a piece, and these bigger 12-inch, yeah, 12-inch, were like $15 a piece, or buy this 4-pack of the 12s and the 6s, for I think it was $34, so I kind of figured that was a no-brainer. And of course, apparently it's raining out here now. Put the aluminum on the side. It's all going to be flush and nice and even. Alright. Now time for some screws. I don't think you need to have a whole bunch of screws in here, but a few to hold it down. Damn, the screws are too long. Ain't that a pisser? The 1¾-inch screws, and I should have bought the 1¼s. Because I'm only going through a 1/2-inch plywood and a 1/2-inch piece of 1x3 there. 3/4-inch piece there. So, I guess for the moment, that's it. Lesson number 27 already on day 2. Buy the right screws.